Pradyumna. Rukmini, in due course, gave birth to her first child, a son, and he was called Pradyumna. Pradyumna's life depicts a true picture of the flickering joys and sorrows of a family life. For on the seventh day of his birth, at dead of night, when all were asleep, he was stolen from his mother's side, mysteriously. Pradyumna was the incarnation of the god of love, Manmatha or Kamadeva. Manmatha had, a long time ago, tried to disturb the penance of god Shiva at the instigation of other gods. Shiva got angry and opened his third eye. By the heat emanating from that eye, Manmatha was burnt down. Since then, he had no body, but was ever active with his five arrows of sense attractions. Manmatha's wife was Rati Devi. Ever since the body of Manmatha was burnt down by Shiva, she had no contact with her husband. Expecting the rebirth of her husband, she was born on earth as Rati Devi. Enchanted by her beauty, she was made a captive by a Rakshasa called Sambara. He wanted to marry her, but she was putting off the marriage by some pretext or other, meanwhile expecting to meet her husband. Sambara came to know that Pradyumna, son of Sri Krishna, would kill him. So, as soon as he was born, on the seventh day, at dead of night, by his magic powers, Sambara took away the child, Pradyumna, from the bed of Rukmini and threw it into the sea. A big fish swallowed the baby. The neighboring fishermen, while fishing, got that big fish and they presented it to the king, Sambara. Sambara directed it to be cooked. Rati Devi was in charge of the kitchen. When the fish was cut open, a baby was found inside it. At that time, sage Narada came that way and explained to Rati Devi that the boy was no other than her own husband, born to Rukmini, but was stolen and thrown into the sea by the cruel Sambara. So, without revealing the news, Rati Devi got the permission to rear the baby, and the boy was growing quite well under her special care. When the boy had grown up to be a sturdy youth, Rati Devi began to make overtures with him for a married life. The boy protested, saying, "O mother, this strange behavior of yours does not fit in with your dignity." Then she explained to him that he was no other than Manmatha, her husband, and narrated the whole history of his birth and the cruel deeds of Sambara. She asked him to kill the demon first, for which she taught him the art of magic fight, with which alone he could win. Immediately, Pradyumna called forth Sambara for a battle. "Shamelessly, you had thrown me into the sea and tried to kill me while I was yet only a few days old. Now it is my turn to take your life out." So saying, he bathed the Rakshasa with arrows, and the demon was no match for Pradyumna in skill of war. So the demon betook to magic to outwit Pradyumna. But Pradyumna made no delay in utilizing the knowledge bestowed on him by Rati Devi and cut off the head of Sambara. Having put an end to his enemy, Pradyumna joined Rati Devi. Both of them reached Dwarka by the magic powers of Rati Devi and entered the palace of Rukmini. Pradyumna was a duplicate of Sri Krishna in beauty and build of body. The ladies in the palace could not be definite whether it was Sri Krishna himself or someone else that has come in. Rukmini looked bewildered. She thought that if her lost son were alive, he would surely be of the same figure as she was able to see then. Sri Krishna, Vasudeva and Devaki assembled there. Sage Narada also arrived there and explained to them the adventures of Pradyumna with Sambara and the great part played by Rati Devi in the struggle. There was real reunion and great rejoicing, and the couple were received with great affection by everybody. They thought that a lost son was actually brought back to life.